subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 4th of October. Outrage erupts after 8 killed amid violence and clashes during Indian farm protest. Muzaffarabad residents protest over water shortage in Pakistan-administered Kashmir. And Taliban says forces destroy Islamic State cell hours after Kabul blast. And now for all the details. Opposition parties in India expressed outrage and farmer leaders vowed to intensify their months-long protest against new farm laws as tension flared a day after at least 8 people were killed in clashes between agitating farmers and the ruling party supporters in northern Uttar Pradesh state. Police said it is investigating the incident and has registered a case against 13 people, including the son of junior interior minister.
Opposition parties in India expressed outrage while farmer unions vowed to intensify their months-long protest against new farm laws a day after at least 8 people were killed in clashes between agitating farmers and the supporters of ruling Bharatiya Janata Party in northern Uttar Pradesh state. Police said they were investigating the Sunday's incident in Uttar Pradesh's Lakhimpur Kheri district and had registered a case against 13 people, including son of Ajay Kumar Mishra, a junior interior minister who allegedly crashed his car into the protesters. Mishra said his son was not present at the incident, but a car driven by their driver lost control and hit the farmers after they threw stones at the car and attacked it with sticks and sword. Several opposition politicians tried to reach Lakhimpur Kheri but were not allowed amid tension as the incident turned into a rallying point in the Uttar Pradesh state, which is slated to go to the assembly polls early next year.
ये बताता है कि किसानों को किसानों के खिलाफ किस कदर भारतीय जनता पार्टी किसानों के खिलाफ है और वो किसी भी विरोध को बर्दाश्त नहीं करना चाहते. ये अंग्रेजों के रास्ते पे चलने वाले लोग अब कृषि कानून में जो लाए हैं वो पूरे ठेके में देकर पूरे हिंदुस्तान के किसानों को वो लूटना चाहते हैं और उसे दबाने के लिए किसी स्तर पे जा सकते हैं जिसका एक उदाहरण लखीमपुर का है.
The legislation, the Farmers Object 2, introduced in September last year, deregulates the sector, allowing farmers to sell produce to buyers beyond government-regulated wholesale markets. Farmers, however, fear the changes will make them vulnerable to big businesses.
Schools across India's western Maharashtra state reopened from Monday for classes 5 to 12 in a phased manner, more than 18 months after the coronavirus outbreak forced their closure. In rural areas, physical classes will resume for classes 5 to 12, while in urban areas, in-person education will restart for those in classes 8 to 12. Southern Kerala state also reopened colleges on Monday.
Schools across India's western Maharashtra state resumed physical sessions for classes 5 to 12 on Monday after being shut for over 18 months in the wake of the COVID-19 pandemic. Armed with school bags and masks, students were welcomed with flowers and sweets at a school in Pune city as they arrived to attend classes after a long period. In Mumbai city, students were seen attending classes in adherence with the COVID-19 standard procedure protocols. Physical sessions have started for classes 5 to 12 in rural areas and for classes 8 to 12 in urban areas of the state. Talking about the COVID-19 management and the precautions, a teacher in Bhai Kabibi school said every precaution is in place, while students expressed happiness over resumption of offline classes.
यहाँ आकर ऐसा महसूस ना करें कि वो घर से दूर है तो उनकी स्थिति क्या होगी, उनको कुछ हो तो नहीं जाएगा, पूरा ख्याल रखा गया है. हर एक बच्चे के लिए सैनिटाइजेशन प्लस सारे टीचर्स जो है सब वैक्सीनेटेड टीचर्स हो चुके हैं, जो नहीं हुआ है उन्होंने आरटीपीसीआर टेस्ट करवा लिया है और वो सब भी नेगेटिव है, तो कोई प्रकार की प्रॉब्लम्स बच्चों को नहीं होने वाली है।
बहुत खुशी मिल रही है, सब फ्रेंड्स सब मिलेंगे वापस, तो ऐसे ही माहौल रहेगा और है ना टीचर वीचर मिलेगी, अच्छे से पढ़ाई होगी ऑफलाइन में, ऑनलाइन में अच्छे पढ़ाई नहीं होगी।
India in March last year had ordered the closure of schools, colleges and other education institutions and pushed for classes to move online to curb the spread of the deadly virus. But with COVID-19 cases declining, schools and colleges were reopened. Southern Kerala state also reopened colleges even amid a daily tally of over 12,000 cases. Meanwhile, India registered 20,799 new cases in the last 24 hours. With this, India's total caseload touched 33.83 million and death toll stands at 448,997.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistan's Jamiat Ulama-e-Islam Fazl Party Chief Maulana Fazlur Rahman has slammed both Islamabad and Washington for not recognizing the Taliban government in Afghanistan. Pakistan, which is considered close to the Taliban, has indicated support amid a looming economic crisis in the war-torn country, but not yet formally announced recognition.
Pakistan's Jamiat Ulema-e-Islam Fazl Party Chief Maulana Fazlur Rahman has slammed both Islamabad and Washington for not recognizing Taliban as legitimate rulers of Afghanistan, as he urged for support for the Islamist group amid an ongoing economic crisis in the country. During an address to party members in Peshawar on Sunday, Rahman said America should immediately recognize the Taliban government in the light of the Doha Agreement. He called incumbent Pakistan PM Imran Khan-led government's foreign policy as flawed and said, Islamabad's silence over the Taliban government's recognition is beyond understanding. Pakistan, which is considered close to the Taliban, has indicated support for the Taliban-led government in Afghanistan, calling for an inclusive government, but not yet formally announced recognition. It has also called on the international community to unfreeze assets and continue to provide foreign aid to neighboring Afghanistan as it faces an economic meltdown. Pakistan fears that an economic and humanitarian crisis will have a spillover effect on it. It already hosts nearly 3 million Afghan refugees.
Moving on, locals in Pakistan-administered Kashmir recently staged a protest against construction of mega dams by Pakistan and China in the illegally occupied territory, which they said has led to an acute water shortage. They blamed the rampant destruction of natural resources in environmental degradation, but Islamabad has continued to ignore their plight.
Locals and activists in Pakistan-administered Kashmir have continued to protest against the mega dam projects proposed to be constructed by Chinese companies on the Neelam and Jhelum rivers in the illegally occupied region. In a recent demonstration in Muzaffarabad, protesters highlighted the environmental damage caused due to Neelam-Jhelum hydropower project and said the city was already facing a 60% water shortage and a rise in temperature due to the so-called development project. They blamed that Pakistan and China have been jointly plundering the natural resources in Pakistan-administered Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan, severely affecting the ecology in the region.
Jogat Nawaz Mir Sahib ne jis tarah kaha ye dual standard jo Imran Khan jo hai puri duniya mein ja ke climatic changes aur uski baat kar rahe hain, lekin yahan azad Kashmir ke aur specially Muzaffarabad ke logon ke sath jo zulm aur jo inki insani jano ke sath jis tarah khela ja raha hai, ab dengue का जो फैलाव है वो सिंपली जो है सिर्फ इस वजह से है जो दरिया का ये रुख मोड़ा गया और उसके बाद जो है जो टेम्परेचर में जो राइज है इस टाइम पे आप सब लोग यहाँ मुजफ्फरबाद के रहने वाले लोग आपको पूरी तरह अंदाजा है कि इस टाइम पे गर्मी की शिद्दत किस हद तक कम हो चुकी होती थी।
Pakistan and China have also signed an agreement for a 700 megawatt Azad Patan Hydel Power project and 1,100 megawatt Kohala project on the Jhelum River, which has compounded the worries of the locals. They say Islamabad has continued to maintain an oppressive attitude and has so far ignored even the basic demands of the common public.
In news from Afghanistan, Taliban government forces destroyed an Islamic State cell in the north of Kabul late on Sunday, spokesperson Zabihullah Mujahid said, after a blast outside a mosque in the Afghan capital killed and wounded a number of civilians. The local affiliate of Islamic State, known as ISIS Khorasan, remains unreconciled to the movement which swept to victory over the Western-backed government in Kabul in August.
Taliban spokesperson Zabihullah Mujahid on Monday said that the government forces destroyed an Islamic State cell in the north of Kabul late on Sunday after a blast outside a mosque in the Afghan capital killed and wounded a number of civilians. In a statement on Twitter early on Monday, Zabihullah said the ISIS base was entirely destroyed and all of the ISIS members inside were killed as a result of this decisive and successful attack. There was no confirmation that the operation was directly connected with Sunday's blast, which appeared to be the most serious attack in the Afghan capital since the withdrawal of US forces at the end of August. Survivors of the deadly blast outside the mosque in Kabul were being treated at a hospital in Afghan capital on Sunday evening. The local affiliate of Islamic State known as ISIS Khorasan has already claimed to have carried out attacks on Taliban targets and remains unreconciled to the movement which swept to victory over the Western-backed government in Kabul in August. Sunday's violence and a string of smaller incidents in recent days in areas including Nangarhar on the border with Pakistan and Parwan north of Kabul have shown that security threats have not disappeared. Islamic State has claimed responsibility for bomb attacks in the eastern city of Jalalabad, as well as for a suicide attack that killed 13 US troops and scores of Afghan civilians who had crowded outside the Kabul airport gates, desperate to secure seats on evacuation flight.
Moving on, India's Foreign Secretary Harshvardhan Shringla on Monday called on Sri Lankan Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa and held a productive discussion with him on further consolidating the multifaceted bilateral partnership. Shringla, who arrived in Sri Lanka on Saturday on a four-day visit, later jointly inaugurated four projects in the housing and education sectors with Sri Lankan Foreign Minister G.L. Peres in the presence of several cabinet ministers and lawmakers. Indian High Commission, in a tweet, said these projects completed with Indian assistance exemplify India's strong and multifaceted development cooperation profile in Sri Lanka. Both the leaders held bilateral discussions focused on early conclusion of projects proposals and enhancing connectivity that would help accelerate Sri Lanka's economic recovery. Shringla later called on Sri Lankan Finance Minister Basil Rajapaksa and discussed India-Sri Lanka economic and commercial ties and post-pandemic economic recovery by taking forward joint projects of mutual benefit. He also held delegation-level meeting with the Sri Lankan counterpart Jayanath Kolambaj to review bilateral cooperation. Farmers in India's northeastern Manipur state are seeing a new ray of hope as two crops, Hathe Chili and Taminglong Orange, known for their unique flavor and color, have finally been awarded the geographical indication tag. This has brought cheer to the locals engaged in agriculture sector as they expect the move will boost the sales.
Hathe chili, which is found in Sirarikong village in India's northeastern Manipur state, is known for its unique color and flavor. These red chilies grow over 8 inches and are packed with rich vitamins. Villagers in Sirarikong expressed their happiness as Hathe chilies was recently granted the geographical indication or GI tag by the Indian government, along with the unique Taminglong oranges found in the state. They said such recognition will further boost the sale and demand of their produce.
See, I go in the higher of the yam no nungai ba. I give walk alone the go. And go, I ngak na te kunzam yam so yam na nungai ba pawi. Maram di briti bi na hujik I go bo masakang bi re hai bise. I go ya dup mati ki nungai ba pau zai hai bise hai zai ding. Na zari. I go ta dok pa ya drab ni na. Low wishing it is he income she lay in a water so one. I don't want to say at the book.
Chili farming has become one of the main sources of income for Sirarikong village because of its favorable climatic condition. Each family in the village produces about 40 to 200 kilograms of chilies every year. These chilies are sold for rupees 500 to 600 per kilogram in the market. The Manipur government has been organizing Hathai Festival and Orange Festival annually to promote both the unique chilies and oranges and boost the agricultural sector.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.